I'm digital artist Aaron Rutten, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to install the Wacom Intuos bundled software. First, we'll go to wacom.com/start/intuos. That'll take us to this page here, where we have some instructions about how to install the tablet, download the drivers, and download the bundled software. Now, if this is your first time registering a Wacom product, you'll need to create an account under My Account. Go ahead and fill out all the necessary information, and then click on the Next button. Answer a few quick questions about how you'll be using this tablet, and then create your Wacom ID. Now check the email that you registered with, and you should have this confirmation email with an activation link. And now your account has been created. To download the bundled software, you go to the left menu under Software Library, and then click on Register Product. You'll have to enter your product ID, and that can be found on the bottom of the Wacom Intuos box. Enter that serial number on the Wacom registration page, and then go ahead and click Next. Then click on View Software Library. Next, carefully choose the correct operating system for your computer. If you're working on a Mac, choose Mac. If you're working on a Windows computer, choose Windows. But make sure not to choose the wrong one here. That takes us to the software library, which shows us all of the bundled software that's available to us in our region, depending on the model that was purchased. Now, I have the Wacom Intuos Medium, which means I can get Clip Studio Paint Pro, Corel Painter Essential 6, and Corel Aftershot 3, and I can download all three of them. So you choose Add to Library, Select. That'll show you the license key that you can use to register the software. Then you click on Download to download the installer for the application. I'm going to go ahead and download all three applications. Now it's important to note that you can always go back to account.wacom.com and you can access this software library page, your serial numbers, and your download links for the software. So let's go ahead and install some of the software and try it out. I'm going to start with Clip Studio Paint Pro. I'm going to double click on the installer file and just follow all the instructions to install it. Then I'll click on the program icon to go ahead and launch it. Now it's going to go ahead and take a minute to load some assets here. But once you've got it open, go up to the top left and click on Paint, and that will prompt you to enter your license key. Go ahead and type that in, and then click on Register License. Then you'll be able to use the full version of Clip Studio Paint Pro. So we'll go ahead and click back in the top left on Paint, and then we can start painting. Now I'm just going to do a few test doodles here to make sure that this is working. Keep an eye out for a Clip Studio Paint tutorial that I'll be releasing very soon. There are also pastels and crayons. If you click on that category, let's try the crayon. You should be able to control the brush size and opacity with your pen pressure, depending on the brush you have selected. If not, you may want to go to the File menu, and then look under Preferences, and then look under Tablet, and just make sure that WinTab is selected as your driver. If that doesn't help and you still don't have pen pressure, watch until the end of this video because I'm going to explain how to calibrate your pen and the Wacom tablet properties. Now let's test out some paintbrushes. We'll click on the paintbrush tool, and then there are some different categories of media and then presets. We can make this palette wider if we want it to by dragging it wider. Let's try transparent watercolor, and our color picker is way down in the bottom left. That's a strange place for it, but that's where it is. You can move it somewhere else if you like. And you can see if I use light pressure, then I get a lighter mark that kind of blends, and if I use firmer pressure, I get a more opaque mark. I'm going to go ahead and choose a different color like this blue, and I can kind of mix them together depending on how much pen pressure I use. As I mentioned earlier, we can calibrate that pen pressure, which I'll show you toward the end of this video. Let's try oil paint now. We'll choose a green color, put down some oil paint, and then we'll pick another color to blend into it. How about something like this gold color here? We can see we can blend them kind of together and you get a nice oily effect. There's also airbrushes if we select the airbrush tool, and we can make a very big airbrush, which is nice. I'm going to put down a little bit of oil paint on top of that using a lighter color, and let's take a look at the blenders because blenders are very important to me in art applications. We'll select the blender category. We have the blend brush here, which is kind of a wet blending. We have this blender here, which is a little bit more smudgy, called fingertip. Then we have a running color on fiber, which is more of a broken up kind of effect. And then soothing watercolor is a more oily look, or kind of a wet look. And I think there's a pretty decent variety of blenders here. So that's as far as I'm going to go into the demo of Clip Studio Paint. Let's take a look at Painter Essential 6 now. We'll go ahead and install that. I'll enter the serial number from the Wacom website. And then once it's finished installing, I'll click on the application to open it, and we can play around with Corel Painter Essential 6. Now, in my opinion, this is really the best application for painting and drawing, although Clip Studio Paint does work well also. It just kind of depends on your preference and what you're going to use. If you're doing more comic books and manga, you might prefer Clip Studio Paint. However, if you're doing fine art and drawing and painting, photo painting, cloning, then Corel Painter Essentials is going to be the way to go. If you want to learn how to use this application in more detail, check out my tutorial about Corel Painter Essentials 6. I'll put a link down in the video description. But you can see, just like in Clip Studio Paint, there's different categories of brushes, and I can draw and paint. So let's take a look now at Corel Aftershot, which is kind of like a Photoshop or Lightroom equivalent. You can use it to edit photos. So on the left, we have a file manager. Let's go ahead and open file. We'll select a photo here. That photo will pop up over on the left, and we'll just double click on that photo to begin editing it. It opens here in the center in our artboard, and then over on the right, we have all of the different sliders that will control the different properties. Exposure will make it lighter or darker. Highlights will help reduce some of the highlights if it's overexposed. Then we can add some fill light if we want to brighten up the background. Blacks we can use to make it richer or more dull. You can use undos too if you want to go back. Then we can add some saturation to make it more colorful. We can also sharpen it by turning on sharpening. Then you can add more or less sharpening if you want. And you can toggle this box on and off to do a before and after to see the effect that the sharpening is having. Now, if you don't want to have to mess with all these sliders, you can always click on the auto level button. And then there's also perfectly clear, which also gives you another result. And I think I kind of like the way that that looks. We can do some more editing over on the far right. We can go to detail, and there's some settings for lens correction and a few other things. For example, we could add a vignette here, which kind of draws the focus in towards the center of the photograph and helps it look more dramatic. Let's click on the plugins tab now, and we can play with the different individual colors. We can click enable, and then we can adjust the reds to make them lighter or darker. We can do the same with the oranges, and we can control each individual color. You may also want to optimize your preferences by going to File Preferences. And then if you look under Performance, you can choose how much of your computer is utilized, especially look under I/O threads, because if you're using an SSD or solid state drive, you can increase this to between 2 and 4 to get better performance. I'll go ahead and click Apply and then OK. And on some computers, that can give Aftershot 3 a boost. So once you're happy with your photo, you can go ahead and save it. To do that, you can go to File, and then Export, Export Files. And then you can choose all of your different settings here. I'm going to go ahead and save this as a TIFF, which is higher quality than JPEG. You'll always want to save your edited files as a high quality format because JPEG will compress your image. Only save as JPEG if you need to in order to make the file smaller to post it on the web. So you can feel free to explore all the different settings here. You can export it to a source folder, which is where the file is located currently, or you can choose a folder. I've gone ahead and exported that image, and I'll open it here in Windows. And you can see here's the edited version of my photo of a mushroom. Pretty cool, huh? You can do a lot more with Aftershot if you upgrade to Aftershot Pro. There's a special deal you can get if you upgrade now. If you don't like this message, you can turn it off. Same goes for Corel Painter. On the welcome screen, you can upgrade to the full version of Corel Painter 2018, which I would highly recommend, because then you'll be able to follow along with all of my great tutorials that I post on YouTube. And this is a great deal on Corel Painter. Now I want to talk a little bit about customizing your Wacom Intuos to work alongside these applications. We'll go to our Wacom tablet properties, and we'll look under Pen. Here's where you can set the pen pressure calibration, so you can adjust the tip feel. I press really hard when I draw, so I set mine one notch towards firm. You can also set shortcuts for the pen buttons. You can have them do things like resize the brush and erase and all that kind of stuff. If we look under Mapping, here's where you can set your tablet to work specifically on just one monitor rather than all of your monitors. So just choose the monitor that you want in your setup. Now, depending on the kind of monitor that you're working on, you may want to set the tablet area to customize it. You may also want to have it only work on a portion of a screen. You could do that as well. If your screen is extra wide, then you could also try forced proportions to see if that helps with your tablet. Do a little bit of test drawing in one of your art applications and you'll be able to see what's working best. If you don't like the ripple effect you get when you click with your pen, you can turn off Windows Ink. However, Photoshop requires Windows Ink in order to be able to use pen pressure in Photoshop, so you'll have to leave it on for that application. If we look under Options, there's an option to adjust the pen pressure for compatibility with older applications that only support 1,000 pressure levels, so you can try that if your application isn't responding well to pen pressure. Next, let's look under the Tablet tab, and here's where you can set the shortcuts for your Express keys. You have 4 Express keys, so you could set this to undo or redo or select your brush or all kinds of different stuff. Now you can set this for each application as well, so you can have your express keys work differently in each application. We may need to add Clip Studio Paint here, so just locate the program file and go ahead and add it, and now you'll be able to add shortcuts for Clip Studio Paint and any other application. Now I should clarify that there's also a setting for all and other, so that would control the express keys and settings for all applications except the ones that you've made custom profiles for. So there you go, that's a quick tutorial on how to get set up with the bundled software for your Wacom Intuos tablet. Next, learn how to draw with your tablet with my Ultimate Drawing Tablet tutorial. And if you'd like access to over 1,000 free digital art tutorials, make sure to subscribe to my channel and enable notifications. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.